Welcome back. Well, we just finished up that research, and I promise today I'm going to try to make this to be a lot shorter episode, but it took me only 3 days to upload that last video, so yeah, my internet here can't really handle that big of an upload anyways, so... So anyways, alright, so we've got circuits here, we've got magnetic rings, those are all being fed into these matrices, and then we are now set to try to do some more research. These are going to take the red matrix, which is something I don't want to dive into yet in this video, but we will go ahead and grab this research. This one is fine because we can upgrade our coal to graphite and that burns even more efficiently. We'll go ahead and do this. The thermal power is fine, but it's really not that handy yet at this point. We'll grab this one and definitely for sure that one. These can all be just kind of running in the background as we're working on other things. We'll get some extra speed. There we go. So anyway, so now we've got some time to kind of work on things. One thing is right now we don't have any stone. So we can get a small production line of stone. And as well, I'm noticing I don't have storage built for the items on the line down there yet, so I like to put a little buffer in the kind of in these corners like this, and that way when I need circuit boards or magnetic rings, and they're basically ready for me to just grab them. If I place this one right, I should be able to cover all of those, which is really nice. And then I can grab a few of those because I needed those for the mining machines. I'm also going to need some smelters. Steel research is done, and we're going to need a bit of that here in a few minutes, especially as we get the stone going. Alright, we'll go ahead and harvest these trees around here. Okay, we're doing good on fuel. Well, let's turn this around this way, and we'll grab that, and I think we will put one more down right there, and then we can put that in the middle of those. Probably wouldn't hurt to get a few more of those going here shortly. So grab plates out of there so that we can start working on that. There is no silicon on these starter planets other than what you can gather out of these little rocks occasionally. You'll get a random chance anytime that you harvest these of getting silicone, so, but you can refine it out of stone. It's expensive because it takes a lot of time and a fair amount of energy to get it, but nonetheless, you know, solar power is kind of preferred, at least for me, preferred form of energy in this early game, so So beside making some stone and glass and other things, we're definitely we need to start smelting some of this into silicon. So we'll probably go ahead and set up a couple of these here. We're going to need to craft a few more of these. You can see that even though, I mean, I haven't really got real intense with the matrix labs up there, the research is still rolling in pretty quickly, which is nice. Okay, so if we place this, well, we should be able to cover the production in these, and we're going to set these to silicon. You can see it takes 10 stone to make one silicon, so like I said, pretty expensive recipe. A lot of energy, you know, going to be consumed just to try to make a few small pieces of silicon here. But it is what it is. So, and then we are going to need a second line of smelters. We might as well just, yeah, kind of go crazy with those. Yet another piece of research done. Alright, we'll grab, we already had 200 circuit boards over there, so grab those, and then we should be able to craft a couple more. For now, I would imagine that one smelter should keep up with what we need to do here. We need some more storage. Oh, need more metal for that. Just go ahead and do three of them here. And we'll just run this straight out of that into storage, and then place a wind turbine to run all that. Alright, that's that side, and we'll probably need to fill this in so that we can continue these lines out as we see fit, but that'll come in a little bit. That's kind of why we're here doing what we're doing right now. So this one here, I think I will turn into glass. It's 2 stone for a pane of glass, and then we'll run that straight into storage. We don't need like a terrible amount of glass here at the first part of the game, so possibly modify that later. We will run more stone in there. And we will turn this into these stone construction material. It's a 1-to-1 ratio. Man, that research is just rolling in.
Display button in the lower right corner of the screen to open real-time distribution details of the ore veins.
So now, when we...
In the planet view mode, you can hold down the middle mouse button drag.
We can actually see all of the veins and where everything's at now.
To point to the front of the North Pole.
So we can see
in the planet view mode, slide the mouse wheel to enter the
lots of oil up in here, it looks like. Coal in with that. So, a lot of oil over here. So, that's what that research, some of that research was about that. Alright, now here, I think for right now, again, I'm just going to run that out. Alright, so this is one of these spots where I'm going to probably use one of these towers. They've got a larger coverage and I don't... I've already got too many windmills in there, so that should cover that well. Alright, so... Oh, didn't set the recipe for this. This is just the high purity silicon. Two of these for each one of those. So, yeah, it's not going to come in real super fast. But I do have some in my inventory that I can give the machine, and it is what it is. We'll get what we need out of it, hopefully. If we go back to the technologies, here is solar collection. We should probably put that in. And then I like to kind of make a beeline kind of for this energy storage, but again, it's going to take the red matrix, which is going to require us getting oil and things going. It's going to be down in here. It's going to be this line and then this line right there. And so we'll put those in there, but now right now I need these I need those motors for that next bit of research, and I'm just going to handcraft those because I don't need that many. There's only 60 of them. So I will just grab things I need to just craft those. Magnetic rings next. There we go. Increase that to 10. Trying to see. Oh, I see. They're going straight into. They're going straight into the research, so I can see I need 46 more. I'll just go ahead and do another 50. Really be hurting for power, because otherwise, yeah. Now we've got 100% satisfaction, so why is the iron not going in okay here? That's really strange. I mean, it's holding the iron. That is really, really strange. I'm going to go ahead and take that out for a second. And then, oop. Maybe that was it. Maybe it's not actually... I bet it wasn't going into the machine. It's actually... I made a mistake when I was placing them and didn't get them into the machine. That's probably what's been going on there. Alright. And it looks like, actually, with the iron being on the outside there, it's actually just not traveling fast enough to get into the building. So we may just need to upgrade the outside line to the green sorters. I could just put two of the yellows, but... That's alright. I'd rather have the faster ones in there anyways, so. Alright. There we go. Wow, we're just messing everything all up here. There we go. Well, we'll just run that in there. Get rid of that one and that one. Okay, so it doesn't look like we are running enough plates over there. Or they're just not coming out of there fast enough, so we're gonna... So this game has an awesome sheet here that actually looks at, and so you can see how, yeah, we're not really producing enough. We're underproducing for our consumption, so... So we do need another... We're not producing enough power, and so you can see that the power is actually flashing there too, so. So we can take care of that for now with just some additional wind power. Actually, now we can actually do those solar panels.
The data shows this is a planet without natural silicone veins. However, you can still obtain some by smelting stone. While you still need a massive silicone collection, you need to find a planet rich with silicone veins as soon as possible.
So, we will hopefully be able to slip one more wind turbine in there. And a few more out along the coast. Looking now. Looks a little better. Okay, finished setting up this. Oops. So if you hover over a building and you hit the less than, that will copy, and then hover over the next building and then hit the greater than sign, and it will paste the recipe right in for you. So it's kind of a nice feature to the game, so that you don't have to go actually in and set the recipe each time. And so, wow. I think I'm going to call this video for today. We didn't really get much done. We did get a fair amount of research. We did get the stone set up. And hopefully this next time when we get back, we can come over here and start to use some of the silicon that we've made and turn that into some solar panels. We'll bring look at bringing some circuit boards over along with some copper ingots and and get a little bit of a solar production line going on over here. Just looking around to see whether we had any copper over here. I don't, so we may just leach a little bit off, because we're not going to need a huge number of solar panels as far, well, we will, but they can be built gradually over time. We don't need them all built at once, but we also need some steel production going on, which I'm hoping to as well be able to get set up. And so, but that'll be next video. So this is Brutal. Thank you for joining me for this video. I hope you liked it, and have a great day. Thank you.